in a world where absolutely anything is possible, let me guide you to a place, an oasis. It is the hiding place for our true selves. It is a sanctuary. Thank you for joining me. My name is Vani, and I am the Tarot Tatler. I'm going to dive right into your Tatler, Taurus. There we go. And what your reading is about, Taurus, is the Queen of Intelligence. This is a queen who speaks from life experience. She has incredible insight, perceptiveness. She's witty. She has a forthright personality. So Taurus, let's see how this ties in with your reading. Now your first card out, Taurus, is the Lovers. With the Lovers, it talks about taking a journey within ourselves in order to discover who we truly are. And once we are able to accept ourselves and the role that we have to play, then we are able to extend that to somebody else. With the Lovers, we could be talking about a soul connection to people that are completely different, but come together to play out their destiny. Now, Taurus, in your mind space, you are hoping to be able to work on what you deem to be your true match. It doesn't matter if you have to put in the sacrifice. It is something you want to be able to do. What's ruling you, Taurus, is trying to get your mind space into a calmer place. Maybe it is you trying to get to that oasis, but it's a place from where you are able to enjoy your present moment. In your fears is a queen of strength. This is the Queen of Wands. She's fearless. She is someone who wouldn't allow anyone to hold her back. She is at her creative peak, and getting to that calmer space in your mind allows you to be able to tap into that energy, Taurus. With the Six of Wisdom, this talks about soulmate energy, a soul connection, someone we may have grown up with, someone we knew when we were younger, or someone that we've spent many lifetimes together with, Taurus. You will have remembered moments, perhaps, similarities, a knowing. Now, Taurus, what you should know is that whatever the Lovers means to you, it's going to weigh you down in some way. It may have you feeling as though you are doing this on your own. Wow, the Nine of Coins. This sits in your hidden position, Taurus. This is something that you may have to accomplish alone. The Nine of Coins talks about abundance, being able to reap the benefits of what you have sown in the physical world, Taurus. But it also talks about going at something alone. Now, what's brought you here, Taurus, is some kind of illusion. Not everything regarding the Lovers, your soulmate connection, your soul path, not everything was presented the way you expected. Maybe there were some elements that were disguised as something else. Maybe this is you knowing that you don't have all of the information, Taurus. Wow, with the Queen of Wands energy. This is you possibly creating an illusion. Something that is directly related to your lover's Taurus. And the reason you create this illusion is because of a Queen of Wands. Now, a Queen of Wands could be fire energy, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Or this could just be the energy that you are tapping into. But either way, Taurus, this is something that you are going to work on. The energy taking you into the future. Wow. Here's your Six of Strength. This is recognition. Recognizing the space that you are entering. Recognizing that you are able to clear your mind in order to be able to enjoy your present moment to its absolute fullest, Taurus, in the physical world. Here is you working with the Queen of Wands. Now, this might be you working on some kind of project. This might be you, Taurus, exhibiting the energy of the Queen of Wands, somebody who is at her creative peak, somebody who has many talents and skills. Wow. With the Hierophant, this could be you working on a long-term commitment, Taurus. Or this could be a Taurus in your energy. Someone who you might have grown up with, someone who you might have spent previous lifetimes together with, but in the physical world, you are busy working on traditions. You are working maybe with a Taurus, with a Hierophant, we're talking about everything that came before, why we think the way we do, why we have the customs that we do. Now, what it is you're trying to avert, Taurus, is possibly some kind of competition. This might be a conflict. This might be too many people around. Each adding a wand that you would have to bear, it is moving away from this, Taurus. That is what is your intention in your hidden position is the Wheel of Fortune. A reminder that life is about cycles, that we have happiness and sadness and grief. We could experience it all at the same time, in one day, simultaneously. Now, what has brought you here, Taurus? Wow. This is doing some kind of research. This is looking up information. This is possibly you looking at what's in your advice section. But we'll see when we get there, Taurus. Now, whatever research or whatever it is you were busy on, Taurus, in the past, it is something that you did in, could I call it a bubble? This is a protective place, a place that keeps you protected in order to be able to accomplish what it is you are meant to accomplish. It is having done all of the healing, and you sit here in introspection, maybe sitting and waiting in order to step forward towards the Queen of Wands or to embody her energy, Taurus. whatever success, whatever recognition you have in your physical world, you look at it from a space of introspection, Taurus, with the hermit energy. This is from considering all that is. And while you might be spending time alone, Taurus, there is a guardian angel that's there to help you along. What's taking you, or what kicks off your near future, Taurus, is the King of Intelligence. Now this could be an air sign, an Aquarius, a Libra, or a Gemini. Or this could be a king who embodies the energy of the King of Intelligence, someone who's the source of valuable advice, an innovator. This is someone at the top of his field. He's intellectual, possibly is able to cover a few subjects. He's objective, diplomatic. This is you working with the King of Intelligence. Or this is the King of Intelligence working with you, embodying the energy of the King, Queen of Strength, Taurus, the Queen of Wands. Wow. And as I say it, this is working hard. This is putting your shoulder to the grindstone, Taurus. This is sleepless nights trying to make sure that whatever it is you are doing in the physical world is successful. This could be you working on your long-term commitments, or this could be you working hard with a Taurus. Now, what it is you are busy looking at, Taurus, is you are trying to find out the path to emotional fulfillment, the space where you are able to accept your present moment and allow it to be. It is the space that takes us from reacting to being able to receive the message that is being given to us at any given point. Wow, and you want to be able to do this quickly. Now, Taurus, I have to tell you that this cycle, the one that sees you with single energy, the one that is tagged on to the Wheel of Fortune, things moving in your favor, this is going to happen really quickly. With the Chariot, it could mean that you are moving towards what you would deem your wish fulfillment. And what else, Taurus, that you need to note is that it is through this difficulty, this is through feeling weighed down, this is through having whatever it is you have in your environment, that you are able to reach your wish fulfillment. The way to go is through, not around. Now, in your outcome, Taurus, with Temperance, having found the balance with whatever it is you are investigating in the physical world, Taurus. With Temperance, we could be talking about a Sagittarius. With the Five of Strength, experience exactly the energy of the Five of Wands. This is a collaboration. Something you are going to do from within your protective space, Taurus, that you had in the past. Whatever it is that you are spending time alone on, Taurus, there's a huge significance on it. It is about catching that shooting star. It's about having made a wish and having it granted. The time that you spend alone is very significant time for you, Taurus. With the star, we could be talking about an Aquarius. With the sun, we talk about success. we talk about victory, Taurus, with the King of Intelligence and the Star, we could be specifically referring to an Aquarius, something that brings happiness into our lives. Wow. This is successfully doing the healing that is required, Taurus, with the Four of Swords. So, Taurus, I wish you all the best. I hope that you've enjoyed this tattle. And until your next one, bye for now.